Hi, my name is Isabel Early, and the basics of quantum physics aren't really all that difficult to understand. In pop culture, quantum physics is stereotyped as this esoteric, abstract field that only super geniuses can even begin to comprehend. When I tell people that I want to go into particle physics when I'm older, one of the most common responses I get is this: "Oh, you must be so smart. I could never do that." And even though it's technically a compliment, it's never sat quite right with me. For one, I don't think I'm all that much smarter than the average person, and I don't think that my intelligence is what has allowed me to learn so much about quantum physics. I've been able to delve so deep into this field because, drumroll please, I care about quantum physics. And sure, in order to be a successful physicist, you have to be pretty smart. And if you want to understand all the math behind quantum physics, you have to be pretty smart. But the average person can understand the basics, and I'm going to prove it to you. I'm not calling you average, I'm just saying that I'm explaining it in a way that's easy to understand. Please don't hate me for this. In order to understand a phenomenon like, say, superfluidity, you first have to understand some of the nomenclature. The Pauli exclusion principle says that no two electrons can have the same value for all four of their quantum numbers. These quantum numbers are their principal quantum number, which is the energy of the orbital that they're in, their angular momentum, their magnetic quantum number, and their spin value. This is why the number of electrons in each orbital is limited, because there are only so many spin values allowed at each energy level. So, for example, in the first orbital, there are only two electrons allowed, because there are only two possible spin values, one-half and negative one-halves. However, the Pauli exclusion principle only applies to particles called fermions. Fermions are particles with half integer spin values, like 1 half or negative 3 halves, whereas bosons are particles with whole integer spin values, like 1 or 3. Because the Pauli exclusion principle doesn't apply to bosons, when you remove all of the energy from a system, they will crowd into the lowest energy state available. For example, helium atoms are bosons. So when you cool liquid helium to near absolute zero, its atoms will all crowd into one state. Because they're in one state, they'll move as one continuous body, meaning that you will get superfluids which are able to flow uphill and seemingly defy gravity. Superconductors work for similar reasons. At this point, you might be saying,
"But Isabel, I thought electrical current was the flow of electrons, and didn't you just say that electrons are fermions, which means the Pauli exclusion principle does apply to them?"
And you would be right. However, when you cool a metal to near absolute zero, its free electrons will form what are called Cooper pairs. These are pairs of electrons that form bonds. And because these Cooper pairs act as one particle, in order to get the spin value of the Cooper pair, you add together the spin values of the two electrons that make it up. Because these two electrons both have half integer spin values, when you add them together, they form a whole integer spin value, meaning that Cooper pairs are bosons. Therefore, they can all crowd into one energy state and move through the metal with no resistance.